Now here. Please ask your friends to join. I am starting the class now, today's class. Now, here, so let us look at a spectrum of AM signal, singleton AM signal. So it contains impulses only. Why? Because M of T is what? What is M of T? AM cos 2 pi f mt. Obviously, so if M of T itself is cos function, you get all our impulses. Because C of T also cos, M of T also cos. What do you get? You get all our impulses, isn't it? Now, so here we got all the components. This is the upper side band. This is the lower side band. Same thing this side. This is upper side band. This is the lower side band. Okay. Now, so what is the this amplitude is AC mu by 4. This is also AC mu by 4. What about this amplitude? AC by 2. Okay. Now here, what's the bandwidth? What is this gap? Phi is the FM. What is the FM? FM is the highest frequency component of message band, message signal, or it is a message bandwidth. Okay. Now, so let us start today's class. I explained demodulation. What is demodulation? Recovering your message signal from the modulated signal. So it will be done by envelope detector or diode detector, which is very simple. And remember, this is works fine. ED works fine if and only if mu is less than or equal to 1. If mu is more than 1, you cannot demodulate AM by using this detector or this envelope detector. So this is a simple circuit. Okay, I explained everything in the last class. This principle of operation. So what exactly happens is just charging, discharging. So that gives you the output. Okay, here tau equal to RC is the discharging time constant, which should be moderate. It should be neither too large nor too small. Okay. I told you the reason also. If it is too small, it cannot follow the envelope. If it is too large also, it cannot follow the envelope. Okay. So if it is between 1 by FC and 1 by FM, then only you get the desired output. Okay. So this is one of the important things to remember when it is concerned to the envelope detector. What are the advantages? As you see the circuit diagram, it is very simple, low cost, and this is the AM radio receiver which contains an envelope detector as a demodulator. You might have seen these things. This is a receiver set. What is AM radio means? Amplitude modulation radio, which means transmitting the your audio using amplitude modulation, and this is a receiver. Okay. So as you know, effect of over modulation. So this is what you get, which is not at all proportional to M of T. In fact, it is proportional to what? Mod of M of T. Okay. Now, so after looking at this AM, what is the advantage of AM and what are the disadvantages of AM? What are the disadvantages? Okay. We'll discuss later otherwise. Okay. Tell me now, what is the disadvantage of AM as of now? Anyone? So after studying all these things, what can you say about the disadvantage of AM? Anyone? What are we wasting here? What is that? It is a bandwidth inefficient. Why? Because we are wasting bandwidth. How much bandwidth we are requiring? Why is the message bandwidth? Okay, as I told you, it is a resource. You must use it properly. Okay, bandwidth inefficient. Okay, what is the advantage as of now? What is the advantage? It has simple receiver, simple demodulator. Let me take. Okay. Anyway, so we'll discuss further. Now, power calculations in AM. We have to find out how much power is required to transmit an AM signal. Why I am talking about power? Because it is also one of the communication resources. So we're talking about bandwidth and power. Why? They are very, very important. Okay. We already spoke about bandwidth. That is 2W. Okay. Or 2FM, depending upon what kind of signal you're transmitting. Power calculations. Let me take S of T. AC cos 2πfct plus AC KA m of T cos 2πfct. The first term is pure carrier, second term is sidebands. Okay. So what the power means? You must calculate power of this carrier as well as power in the sidebands. Okay. Now here, so what is the power of the signal AC cos 2πfct? What do you say? If I ask you, what is the power of, suppose if I say x of t equal to a cos omega naught t, let me take. What is the power of the signal?
A square by 2.
A square by 2. Which means, so whatever there here, you take square and divide by 2. Okay, they are power signals. Why they are power signals?
Periodic.
Because they are periodic.
Finite power.
Okay. Okay, anyway. So here, okay, this is AC square by 2 because its amplitude is AC. Next. So let me take this sideband term. Here, now I can say that we have m of t as well as cos 2πfct. Both are time functions. Okay. But the frequency of m of t is much, much less than the frequency of this carrier, fc. Okay. Now, what can I say is, here since I have both are time varying functions, what I assume is approximately compared to cos 2πfct, m of t is relatively constant. Do you agree with me? Because m of t varies very slowly compared to the cos 2πfct. Why? Fc, the carrier frequency is much, much more than message frequency. That should be the case generally. Okay. Now, what I assume is, so in this entire term, I'll assume that it is nothing but a sinusoidal with amplitude what? AC KA m of t. Okay. Even though m of t is not a constant, the time varying function, but relatively it is constant. With relative to what? Cos 2πfct. So compared to cos 2πfct, m of t is varying very, very slowly. So that's why I'm assuming m of t as some kind of constant. Now this would be the amplitude of this cos 2πfct. Okay. Now, what about the, since m of t varies at much slower rate than c of t, what is the reason? Fc is much, much more than fm. Okay. Now, what is the power of the signal would be now? So this is the amplitude of this cos term. Obviously, this whole square by 2 means s square, ka square, m of t whole square by 2. Because if ac is amplitude, what is the power? Amplitude square by 2. If this is amplitude, what could be the power? P square by 2. Okay. But so we should take average power. You take expectation. Okay. So expectation means 1 by 2 is a constant, AC square is a constant, K square is a constant. So you take expectation to M of T whole square. Okay. That is some kind of random signal. Okay. Now, what is expectation of M of T whole square? Generally, it is called power. Okay. You assume all other things. Now, so expectation of m of t whole square is something like pm. What does pm stands for? Power of m of t. Okay. Now, so what is the power of the signal? Simply ac square k a square into pm by 2. Power of this pure carrier is ac square by 2. Power of the sidebands is what? Ac square k a square m of t whole square by 2. Otherwise, ac square k a square pm by 2. What is pm? It is the power of message signal. Now you got two powers separately. What is total power? this power plus this power. Okay. Total power P transmitted power T equal to this square by 2 plus this power. Okay, this is total power. How much you got? Total transmitted power is AC square by 2 plus AC square K square PM by 2. Is it okay? Now here we have something called power efficiency. What we have? Something called power efficiency. Okay. Now how it is defined? Power efficiency equal to useful power by total power. It is a ratio of useful power to the total power. Okay. But what is useful power? Power in side bands. How can you say like that? Because so in the spectrum we have total three components. What are they? Carrier, two side bands. As I told you, the entire information is in the side bands, not in the carrier C of T. Okay, so that's why useful power means power in the side bands by total power. Okay, so what is the power in the side bands? Of S square K square into PM. What is total power? S square by 2 plus, you can take common if you want. So S square by 2 common, 1 plus K square PM. Okay, whatever it is. So here, yeah. Now this is the power in side bands by total power. If you do calculations, this is what you get. K square into PM by 1 plus K square PM. What do you get? K square PM by, what do you get? So the power efficiency of AM is K square into PM by 1 plus, what do you got? 1 plus K square into PM. This is about power efficiency. It is simply ratio of useful power to the total transmitted power. Okay. So now let us see power calculation for sinusoidal message signal or power calculation in singleton AM signal. So I am just writing for your understanding purpose. This is what the S of T, singleton AM signal. So what is the power in the carrier? Here all are constants. We don't have any problem now. S square by 2. This is the power in the carrier. Power in lower side band. What is lower side band? AC mu by 2 cost term. AC mu by 2 into cost term. So what is this amplitude of this term? AC mu by 2. AC mu by 2 whole square by 2. That will be S square mu square by 8. Power in upper side band, obviously same. S square mu square by 8. Total transmitted power. How much? What are you transmitting? A carrier, pure carrier, one upper side band, one lower side band. Sum of all these powers. How much is this? This plus this plus this. What do you get? So this is you get S square by 2 into 1 plus mu square by 2. What do you get? S square by 2 into, what do you get? S total transmitted power in single tone modulation is S square by 2 into 1 plus mu square by 2. But what is this S square by 2 actually? Carrier power, power in carrier. We are calling this as PC. PC means carrier power. So that's how we can write this as PC into 1 plus mu square by 2. Okay. is a total transmitted power. Okay, so what is power in side bands? Two side bands, both are having same power. Power in side bands means power in LSB plus power in USB. This plus this. What do you get? S square mu square by 4. S square mu square by 4. But what is S square by 2? PC. So simply it is PC into mu square by 2. Am I okay? Right. Now what is the power efficiency now? As I told you, it is power in side bands by total power. What are the power in side bands? PC into mu square by 2. Okay. By what is total power? PC into 1 plus mu square by 2. PC cancels. What do you get? You get mu square by 2 plus mu square. What do you get? You get mu square by. So power efficiency of AM is mu square by 2 plus mu square. This is very, very important. Remember, it is for watt modulation if message signal is sinusoidal signal. Okay, in general, what is the power efficiency formula? This is in general formula. Okay, so here this in general formula, and this is particularly for if M of T happen to be a sinusoidal signal. Okay, so this is very, very important. You must remember this formula. Okay, as mu increases, N increases. You can find out. Now, so, but we have a limit for mu, correct? Mu cannot be more than 1 for a faithful demodulation. Mu must be always less than or equal to 1. So what is the maximum value of mu now? 1. If mu equal to 1, you get maximum efficiency. Okay? See, if mu is maximum, eta also maximum. What is maximum mu? 1. When mu equal to 1, you get maximum efficiency. How much is that? Put mu equal to 1. How much you get? 1 square by 2 plus 1 square. That means 1 by 2 plus 1. That is 1 by 3. Or in the percentage, it is 33.33. Okay. What do you mean by that? Power efficiency is, suppose if I say power efficiency is 1 by 3. Eta equal to 1 by 3. Which means useful power by total power. Useful power by total power. What do you mean by that? What do you mean by this? Okay. How much you are wasting? You are using 1/3 properly. You are wasting how much? 2/3 is wasted. Are not useful, wasted, unused, not useful. Okay, which means, so in the singleton AM signal, the total power that you are using is effectively is very, very less. Why? Because poor power efficiency, 67% of the power is wasted. Okay, you are only using 33% effectively. Or properly. The many things you are wasting. What is the reason? So please remember one more condition. So this is 1/3 is only for sinusoidal message signal. The power efficiency, the maximum power efficiency is 1/3. That is only for sinusoidal message signal. So the maximum power efficiency is 1/2. Or 50% for any general message signal, which means in AM power efficiency will not be more than 50%. You take any message signal, okay, which means so 50% of the power is used properly, remaining 50% is wasted. Okay, So that is one of the biggest drawbacks of amplitude modulations. It has got poor power efficiency. It has got poor bandwidth efficiency. These are two disadvantages of AM. You're wasting power, you're wasting bandwidth. But ironically, these two are communication resources. You are not using resources properly. Okay. The only advantage of AM is it has got simple demodulator, which is having only basic element like a resistor, capacitor, a diode. Okay. Now remember, so the maximum power efficiency of AM for any signal is 50%. But if you take only sinusoidal, it is even less, one third. Only 33%, 33.33%. Okay. Okay, any doubts so far? You can also ask me, you can message me. So if you don't have any doubts, let us proceed further. Okay. Yeah. Okay, you can tell me what is the reason for this poor power efficiency?
Presence of more useless power.
Why? What is the reason? Okay, tell me. So what is the reason for poor bandwidth efficiency? What is the reason? The reason is you're transmitting two sidebands, even though each sideband contains complete information about message signal. If you transmit one sideband, what will happen? There is no change in the information that you get, but you can reduce the bandwidth. Okay. So why are you transmitting CRT? Even though it is not containing any information, still we are transmitting. The reason for poor power efficiency is what? This pure carrier, which is being transmitted in spite of not carrying any useful information. See, you look at this signal, what information it has? No information, but still we are transmitting. So this is the reason for having poor power efficiency. Okay. Is it okay? So the reason for having poor power efficiency is this pure carrier. So the reason for bandwidth inefficiency is transmitting two sidebands. Okay. But so remember, there is always a trade-off. Okay. Nobody can say that this is the best technique. It's always a trade-off, because so some applications require certain type of modulation techniques. Certain modulation techniques are suited for certain applications. It's always a trade-off. We cannot generally say this is the best technique, this is a bad technique. No, you cannot do such division. Okay, so it always depends upon applications. For some application, this will be good. For some other applications, some other technique will be good. Is it okay? It's always trade-off. What is trade-off? Here, so we are paying for poor power efficiency and poor bandwidth efficiency. But what advantage you're getting? You're having a simple receiver or simplest demodulator. That is called trade-off. At the cost of having simple demodulator, you're paying for power as well as bandwidth. So at one place, we are at loss. At other place, we are at gain. That is called trade-off. Okay. Now, so here, basically it is used in broadcasting. Okay. What are the broadcasting techniques that you know? TV is a broadcast. Radio is a broadcast. So just now I told you AM radio, that is a type of broadcasting. Okay. Where? So in the broadcasting, transmitter receivers. But what happens here? Which are more in number? Transmitter or receivers? In broadcasting applications, which will be more in number? Transmitter or receivers?
Receivers.
receivers. For every transmitter, there are so many receivers. Okay, so in that case, you want your receiver to be simple. Why? Because receivers are in millions in number. You have millions of receivers, but you have very few transmitters. You take AM radio station. How many stations are there? How many AM radio stations are there? Maybe 100. 100 stations may be transmitting from their respective stations. But how many are receiving? Millions. You don't have a number. Okay. So we have so many radio receivers, but only very few transmitters. What is the transmitter? AM radio stations. What is the receiver? Your AM radio receiver. This is just now I shown you. So we have millions of receivers like this. Millions of receivers across the world. But how many are transmitting? Very few, maybe hundreds, not more than that. So here is the trade-off. Here, since the receivers are outnumber the transmitters, our receivers should be simple. When it is possible, whenever your demodulations are simple, your receivers will be simple. Okay, that's why in AM, it is widely used in the broadcasting. Okay, even though you need to spend more money on power and bandwidth, you're wasting power bandwidth. That is okay for us. But the advantage you're getting is a simple receiver or simple demodulator. I'm okay with that. Why? Because so since very few people are transmitting, they can bear the expenses. They're okay with power wastage, bandwidth wastage, because very few people are transmitting. But I need to have a simple receiver because millions of people are receiving. Okay, who will bother about power and bandwidth? Who are transmitting? If you are transmitting, you need power to transmit. Okay, you need bandwidth to transmit. So that's the problem. Those are the problems of transmitters, not receivers. Okay, as for receivers, I should have a simple receiver. I don't bother about how much power is wasted, how much bandwidth is wasted. That is the problem of transmitters or AM stations, not the receivers. Okay, so that is about AM, right? That is widely used in broadcasting, especially radios. Anyway, okay, so let us get into the topic. Yeah, so here as I told you just now, in AM, you can eliminate the carrier, you can eliminate one of the sidebands. If you do so, you don't have any problem with the receiver. Okay, now, so power efficiency can be improved by suppressing the carrier. Next, in the next technique, what I do is I'll remove this carrier. Okay, still nothing will happen. Why? Because this carrier is not carrying any information. Okay, there won't be any loss of information. But what is the advantage you get? You can improve your power efficiency. Why? Because if you don't transmit this term, obviously you are saving power. You're not transmitting this term. You're just transmitting this term. Obviously, you can save the power without loss of information. We are not compromising at the information point of view. Okay? Yeah. Now, so that leads to next technique, that is called double sideband suppressed carrier, DSBSE, which means we are transmitting two sidebands. We are suppressing the third component, that is carrier. Okay, you take this term, you remove this term, you transmit only this term, only transmit two sidebands. Here, this K also not required. We don't need K, just M of T into C of T. Just multiply two things. What are they? Carrier is a signal. So just multiplier, analog multiplier. So that is called double sideband suppressed carrier. What it is called? Another technique, that is called DSBSE. Double sidebands are transmitted, the carrier is suppressed. It is called double sideband suppressed carrier. Now, what is the equation of this DSBSC? You just take M of T into C of T. This is a modulation. Multiplying your message with carrier. Here we don't have any K or something like that. They are not required. Okay. Now how to implement this? Just analog multiplication. Take M of T, multiply with C of T. That's it. It is called product modulator. So what happens? It just, what is property? Modulation property. If x of t is m of t into c of t, what about x of f? What is c of t? Kc cos omega ct. Obviously, kc by 2, m of f plus fc plus m of f minus fc. What are two major components? Lower side band, upper side band. No carrier at fc. Okay. Yeah. So these are some things which we'll discuss now. What about spectrum? You take the spectrum of AM signal, just remove that, this component carrier. So in the AM spectrum, what we had? We had a component, an impulse at FC like this. Here also we had impulse. Just remove those two impulses. And there is no K also. I hope you can okay with this. You are okay with this spectrum of DSBSC. What about bandwidth? It is remain same. 2W, twice the bandwidth of message signal. Upper side band, lower side band. That's it. Okay. Now, how does the waveform look like? Something like this. Okay. But so one thing we have to observe here is. Okay, so what is happening here? This red color line is a message signal. Okay, what can you observe here? Okay, so before that, so let us discuss phase reversal. What is the phase reversal? Suppose here you take sine waveform. This is something like x of t. Phase reversal means what happens? Next, you take minus x of t. What is this part? Minus x of t. X of t minus x of t. Now, at this point, it is phase reversed. What happened? Phase reversal means, so it was positive, now suddenly it is becoming negative or reverse. Sign changes. If it is positive, it becomes negative or reverse. If it is negative, it becomes positive. Okay. So this was x of t. So actually how it should be? If it is positive signal, how it should be? It should be like this. But suddenly it is becoming negative. The waveform is suddenly becoming negative. So this portion represents phase reversal or phase shift by how much? 180 degrees. A phase shift of 180 degrees or phase reversal, which means x of t becomes minus x of t or minus x of t becomes x of t. Sign changes, positive to negative or negative to positive. That is called phase reversal. Is it okay? The waveform changes its sign. Here, this is a DSBSC waveform. What is happening here? Actually, you observe this waveform. It was like this, like this, like this. After that, it should have gone like this. But what happened? You observe this portion and this portion. They are exactly negative of each other. Either these two, they need to have each other. Okay, which means, so this red color line is message signal. Okay, so what happened? Whenever this message is crossing zero, this is zero axis, no? This is zero axis. Whenever this message is crossing zero, there is a phase reversal. You observe here. Here is a phase reversal. What is the point here? This message signal, which is in the red color, is crossing zero. Same thing happens here. Whenever message signal is crossing zero, at that point, phase reversal is happening. Here also you can observe. Okay, so that should be remembered in case of DSBSC. In DSBSC, whenever message crosses zero, there would be a phase reversal in the carrier, in the modulated signal or the modulated carrier. Okay, so that is about DSBSC. Simple. It is just next technique. Okay, DSBS means double sideband suppressed carrier. You take AM signal, you suppress the carrier or remove the carrier component, pure carrier component. So you get DSBSC. The name itself indicates it has got two sidebands without carrier. Okay. Now, so let us go to the single tone signal. When M of T is AM cos 2 pi FM T, C of T. Obviously, what is M of T and C of T? These two. So X of T is AM AC cos 2 pi FM T into cos 2 pi FC T. Yeah, so this is again I'm applying cos A into cos B. What do you say? Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B by 2, overall by 2. This is the DSBSC signal. This is the upper sideband, this is the lower sideband. That's it. Upper sideband, lower sideband. So what is the upper sideband amplitude? AM AC by 2. What is the lower sideband amplitude? Again, AM AC by 2. What is spectrum? How it will be? So we have a cos term, two cos terms, which means you get four impulses. So what about amplitude? AM AC by 4. It becomes 1 by 2, no? AM AC by 4. These are the four cos terms. Okay. So you go to the spectrum of DSBSC. So remember, this is spectrum whenever M of T happen to be a AM cos 2 pi FMT. So this is upper sideband, this is a lower sideband. What was missing? So in the AM, you observe the spectrum of these two. This is a lower sideband. Here in AM, we had a component at FC, which is AC by 2. That is missing. So everything is same. This is missing. Here also we had a component at FC minus FC. That is missing. So remaining things are same. One more thing is also missing. So here there is nothing like mu. Mu is not defined for DSBSC. We don't need mu here. So what is this amplitude you got? AM AC by 4. In the amplitude modulation, what you had? AC mu by 4, AC mu by 4. But here we don't need mu. That is not defined for DSBSC. Mu is only for AM. Okay, so what happened here? Only two sidebands. Upper sideband, lower sideband. With magnitude, AM AC by 4, here also AM AC by 4. So that is about spectrum of DSBSC. If at all, M of T happened to be a sinusoidal. If it is not sinusoidal, this is a spectrum. Okay? Without components. Just a minute. So they will send one info. What is this? Vainoka. Vainokaya. Okay. See here. Here we don't need our envelope to be positive. We don't need to be, it don't need to be positive. What the purpose of Ka? I told you. Okay. So the question is, why there is no Ka in case of DSBSC? Okay. So here I told you, we take mu less than equal to 1. Why? Whenever mu is less than equal to 1, we get envelope. Same as amplitude. That is same as, I mean, that is positive. Okay. In DSBSC, we don't need envelope to be positive. In DSBSC, envelope need not be proportional to M of T. It need not be proportional to M of T. Why? Because suppose if you take S of T, it's simply M of T into AC cos omega CT. M of T into C of T, but C of T is AC cos omega CT. Now you take mod of S of T. Mod of S of T. That is nothing but envelope. What is this? Mod of M of T. Okay. So envelope is mod of M of T. So if it is Ka is there or not, doesn't make any difference. K is a constant. If K is 1, 1 into M of T. If K is 2, not 1, if K is 2, what is 2 into M of T? 2 into mod of M of T. If K is 1 by 2, if it is 1 by 2 into mod of M of T, so K does not make M of T positive. Okay? So K has no role to play in making mod of M of T always positive. I mean, mod of M of T is same as M of T. It is simply something like amplification or attenuation. Okay. But in AM, what is happening? So what is the spectra, what is the envelope of AM? 1 plus Ka into M of T. Now Ka can make this envelope as positive or negative. I mean, this amplitude is positive or negative because there is a DC shift is there. Here we don't have DC shift here. Directly mod of M of T. If M of T is positive, envelope will be positive. If it is negative, so we can't do anything. Okay. Right. Okay. So that is about DSBSC. Yeah. There is no mu for DSBSC. It is not required. Okay. So what else? Okay, this is the spectrum. This is the spectrum. Okay. Now, what is the bandwidth? 2W, 2FM. So what about power efficiency? Anyone? So can you tell me power efficiency of DSBSC? Who will tell me the answer? I'm asking for power efficiency. Okay, answer me first. What is the power efficiency of DSBSC? How much is that? It is 100% because we are not testing any power. What is the power efficiency? Power in sidebands by total power. So total transmit power. What are we transmitting? Two sidebands. Isn't it? It is 100%. No power is being wasted. We are wasting bandwidth. But we are not wasting power. Okay. So why it is happening? Because we are not transmitting a carrier which is not containing any information. So that is about DSBSC. In DSBSC, you must remember these two things. Envelope of DSBSC signal is therefore different from message signal MRT. So which means that annular detection is may not be applicable for demodulation. One more thing, whenever MRT is crosses zero, there is a phase reversal in the carrier. Okay, so envelope detector may not be suitable for demodulating DSBSC. Why? Because envelope equal to mod of MRT. Okay, now one more thing is whenever message signal crosses zero, at that point there is a phase reversal of the transmitted signal or modulated carrier. Okay, now so if it is not demodulated by ED, how it is demodulated? Okay, here, so first of all, what is the modulation? So we have discussed so many concepts about modulation. Basically, if you multiply MRT into CRT, what is happening here? This is a modulation. This is a modulation. What is happening here? Frequency translation. What is happening? Frequency translation. Now in the demodulation, I want to have retranslation. How can you do retranslation to original frequencies? So we are translating frequency, that is the modulation. Demodulation should be reverse. Okay, how can you do retranslation to original signals? How can you do so? Any logics, any suggestions? How can I demodulate? So here, how am I modulating? I am modulating multiplying MRT with CRT. This is a part one, modulation. I want to have demodulation. How can I do it? In modulation, we are having frequency translation. How can I do retranslation to the original frequencies? Anything? So let me write here. Obviously, CRT will be always AC cos 2 pi FCT, and this is MRT. Now, how can you do retranslation to original frequencies? That is the demodulation, more or less. Here, we cannot go with ED, envelope detector. We have to think of something else, what that could be. Suppose, if I multiply again with cos omega CT, what will happen? Okay, so if I again multiply S of T with demodulation, if I again multiply S of T with C of T, what will happen? Can you think of it? What is S of T? What is S of T? AC cos 2 pi FC into M of T. So I am again multiplying with what? Cos 2 pi FCT. I am not writing AC again and again. That is okay. So what will happen? So what I am saying is, I am multiplying X of T with cos 2 pi FCT. What is X of T? AC MRT into cos 2 pi FCT. AC MRT into cos 2 pi FCT. Again multiplying with cos 2 pi FCT. What do you get? What happens? AC cos 2 pi FCT, cos 2 pi FCT means cos 2 pi FCT whole square into MRT. But is what is cos square theta? 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. This is theta. Is it okay? Now what I can write? AC by 2 1 plus cos 2 theta means 4 pi FCT into M of T. So what happens now? You further simplify this. What do you get? AC by 2 M of T plus AC by 2 M of T into cos 4 pi FCT. Now the demodulation output should be what? Only M of T. You have to remove this term. It is not required. Okay. How can you remove? By using filters. Okay. So here, this is the demodulation. You take the transmitted signal, again multiply the same carrier. This is AC by 2 and this is something else. So that can be removed by choosing a proper low pass filter. Now this is a demodulator. So we are getting x of t, and that is a transmitted signal or modulated signal. Again, that is multiplied with same carrier, and the result will be passed through low pass filter. You get r of t, which means, so let me take a simple sketch here. So we have a modulator. We are modulating. It is a product modulator, we call. We are modulating by just multiplying M of T with C of T. M of T with C of T. We are getting modulated signal. Let us take X of T. So this is a transmitter part. This is what we are doing in the transmitter. This is a modulator. Okay. How are you modulating? You're taking message signal, multiplying with the carrier, you're transmitting over a channel. So at the receiver, what do you do? What do you receive? You receive X of T. What I'm doing is, again, I'm multiplying with the same carrier. And after that, I am passing through what filter? Low pass filter. Okay, here, so we have two carriers. This is the receiver part, also called as demodulator. This is demodulator. Here, at the transmitter, we have one carrier. This is called incoming carrier. Now, here the trick is, at the receiver also, we have to multiply with the same carrier that we used to modulate. It is called local carrier. It is called local carrier. Okay, here, so the entire process is, entire thing is called synchronous or coherent demodulation. Synchronous or coherent demodulation. Why it is called so? Because the two carriers, the carrier that we are using at the transmitter side and the carrier that we are using at the receiver side should be exactly same. Same in the sense, they should have same frequency, same phase. Amplitude can be different. Okay. So they are having synchronization or coherence in the frequency, in the phase. Okay. That's why it's called a coherent or synchronous demodulator. Okay. Why? Because the two carriers are coherently or synchronously matched with the frequencies and phases. So the frequencies that you are using at the transmitter side should be same as the frequency of the carrier, local carrier, that you are using at the receiver side. Exactly same. They should have same frequency, same phase. Then we say that they are in synchronization or they are coherent. So that's what is called coherent demodulator. You look at the modulator, demodulator, they are exactly same. Is a multiplier, here is a multiplier. The only thing is we have filter. That's it. So modulator, demodulator are same. Yes, they are multipliers. The demodulator side, they have extra filter. Apart from that, everything is same. Okay. So local carrier, incoming carrier. The carrier that we use to modulate is called incoming carrier. The carrier that we use to demodulate is called local carrier. Okay. Here at the receiver side, we have to generate this carrier. Please remember. Okay. We have to produce this carrier at the receiver, which is having exactly same frequency, same phase as that of the carrier that we are using in the modulation part or in the transmitter part. Okay. So this is about, yeah. So local carrier should be replica of the actual carrier at the transmitter. Okay. They should have same phase, same frequency. It is called, so that's what is called synchronous or coherent detection. Now, so let me take a simple thing. What happens if there is a loss of synchronization? Means at the modulator, we are using some carrier. This is a modulator. This is a demodulator. Suppose here we are using some carrier, cos. Cos to Fc. What is the frequency? Fc. What is the phase? Zero. But suppose the carrier that we use as a demodulator may be having different frequencies, different phases. Then what happens? So suppose it is having frequency. Let me take Fc plus some extra frequency del f. Frequency is not same. Phase also not same. Okay. So there is a some shift in the frequency, some shift in the phase. Or there is a difference in the frequency, difference in the phase. Then what happens? It is called loss of synchronization. Here there is a loss of frequency synchronization. There is a loss of phase synchronization. In that cases, what happens? Are you getting my point? If there is a mismatch in the frequency or phase of the carriers that we use in the modulation part, in the demodulation part, then what happens? Okay, so let me take brief review about this. Okay, now here incoming carrier is AC cos to pi epsilon t, but locally generated carrier has got some phase difference, a phase mismatch. Here what is phase? Zero. Here I have phase theta, which is not zero. Let us assume that. Then what happens? If you demodulate like that, what will happen? You multiply these two, cos A into cos B. It is called error. Theta is called phase error in the two carriers. Here they do not have same phase. There is a loss of phase synchronization. Then what happens? You calculate this, you get like this. Yeah. After demodulation, you get AC m of t by 2 into cos theta. What is extra you are getting? Cos theta. It is because of loss of phase synchronization. So actually, if there is a synchronization of phase, what output you got? It is a demodulator. Output of t modulator was AC by 2 m of t. If there is no loss of synchronization. But now what are you getting? You are getting some extra term, AC by 2 into m of t into cos theta. What is this theta? Phase difference between two carriers or error. Phase error. Now this is what the output at the demodulator side. Okay, so here you know already extra term is cos theta. Anyway, so cos theta always between minus 1 to plus 1, which means cos theta is acting as a attenuator, because cos theta is not more than 1, it is between minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, obviously it is something like attenuation. If cos theta is 1 by 2, what happens? It is attenuated. Okay, amplification, attenuation is okay. There won't be any problem with amplification of m of t or attenuation of m of t. No problem. But there is a problem. Suppose if theta equal to pi by 2, what is cos theta? How much? 0. What about r of t? 0 means at the denominator side, you don't get any output. You get 0 output. Okay. So that is the effect of having a phase mismatch between two carriers. Okay. Yeah. So as long as cos theta is not 0, it is just like attenuation. When theta equal to 0, if theta equal to 0 means what? There is no phase error. Means there is a synchronization. But if theta equal to 90 or pi by 2, get 0 output. Is it okay? So phase equal to 90 means what? What do you mean by that? What is the logic? If phase shift is 90, cos becomes sine. Means suppose at the transmitter, if the carrier is cos theta, cos term, at the receiver, if the carrier is sine, the carrier is sine, what may happen? Output will be 0. Because they have phase difference of pi by 2. Okay. So you should make sure that there won't be any phase error which is equal to pi by 2. Other things are okay, except pi by 2 is not desirable. If it is pi also okay. If it is pi by 4 also okay. You don't have any problem with any phase error except pi by 2 or 90 degrees. If it is 90 degrees, you have a problem. Output will be 0. It is called null effect. What is called null effect? So this is about demodulation of DSBS. Okay. Okay, right. So thank you. We stop here.